It's a lot of fancy words, but basically I want to tell you about my obsession is probably a strong word. Let's call it a hobby. So basically I hate compile times. I hate to wait. So I want to do something about that. So, but first, why should you listen to me? First, the drinks are free. I started programming in 2008 when I started studying physics, and I have been a professional C++ programmer for the last 3 years in the medical device industry. And sometimes a fresh perspective is useful to have. Okay, so why should you, or why do I care about compile times? So mandatory XKCD comic, if that's your workplace and your only lunch break is while you're compiling it, then you should probably not listen to me. Genau, we are C++ programmers. We care about control and performance. Compiler is also just a piece of code, so we can optimize it. And at least when I'm developing, I want quick iteration times, so the time between writing my code and seeing if it works should be as short as possible. And yeah, it's good for bug hunting, for implementing new features, and also the new guys in your company will also thank you if they don't have to wait a half an hour for the build to finish. Yeah, and a fresh rebuild is always nice if one isn't sure if something happened with their object files. And of course, if you have a Jenkins or another continuous integration system, there are 10% more performance is always nice. Yeah. Of course, let me ask who of you is programming mostly under Windows? I'm sorry for you, so this will not be for you, because I'm mostly on Linux with GCC. So that was I was focusing on today, but let's get the low-hanging fruits out of the way first. So if your source files are on a network drive, make sure that you have a good connection there, that there's no bottleneck like that 10 Mbit hub under the desk of your coworker. Think about a RAM disk or about pushing for Git in your team. Of course, that's old advice. Get an SSD, if not, consider Zcache, which is basically caching your object file, and if you want to compile the same thing again, you don't have to compile again. Then on GCC, there's a pipe compiler flag, basically that prevents the temporary files from going to disk, but it pipes it directly between the steps. Or you can tell it to store the temp files on a RAM disk, so directly in RAM. Exactly, and use parallel builds. So I know make files and CMake can be scary sometimes, but every hour spent debugging your make files that doesn't want to build in parallel will pay off later. And of course, measure what you have gotten. So that are the low-hanging fruits out of the way. So hard disk I/O shouldn't be a bottleneck anymore, so now we are limited by CPU time. And there was a fun part for me started. So I took the GCC source code and tried to get a faster binary out of it. So disclaimer, I'm not a compiler engineer and I haven't really opened the source code, but I'm a physicist. And I like to poke complex system and see how they respond. Sometimes it goes poorly, but sometimes you get something good out of it. So possible optimizations. So let's say you are in your workplace and the new guy comes to you and says, so this is a part of the lightning talk with audience interaction. He says his algorithm is as fast as he can think about it, but it's still a few percent too slow. And he heard about something magical, like the compiler optimizer, and he asks you which flags he should turn on. So I was able to think of four. Does anybody want to offer one?
All three?
Yeah, all three is one of them. I don't know if I want to turn it on in the compiler, to be honest. I like my result to be correct. Something else?
OS
in certain situation for small executable. Yes, that's, I'm counting that under OS3, but one could measure that one also. So the other ones I had was the link time optimization. Then you can, of course, specify that the compiler should be built only for your CPU and not for anything else, because when will you change your CPU? On the Jenkins, maybe a few times, but there you can automate it with a script. And of course, the big one was profile guided compiling. So, do I have to explain any of these flags, or are they all known? Okay. So basically, that's my test setup. It's mostly for YouTube and for the camera. Basically, I have taken GCC 7.3.0 because that's the one that comes with the Ubuntu 18. And then I have grabbed a random library, that's a linear algebra library from GitHub, threw it on a RAM disk and had it compiled 10 times with the optimized compiler, basically to get the noise out of all this thing. And now let's come to the results. Basically, what took me 2 months of trial and error to get. So that's a little bit much, but I will walk you through it. So basically, I took GCC 7.3.0. Here's the mean compile time of the sample library. So that's not the compile time for the compiler. That was around an hour every time. Then, of course, always when you're showing numbers, you should show some errors. So we can see that there's relatively low noise in the result, so we can somewhat trust them. And here's the speed increase compared to the stock compilers that you got. So we have the default bootstrap that runs with O2. Then I tested O3, O2 for only my CPU. O2 with link time optimization, then all three together, and then I also threw profiled optimization into the mix. And basically, the result is that the big one is the profiled optimization. So 10%, I will take that one. O3 brings a little bit. And native seemed to have slowed it down on my CPU. That was a little bit surprising. And the link time optimization also slowed it down. And you will probably have noticed already that in the profile, there's missing the link time optimization. That's because GCC 7.3 doesn't compile with link time optimization and profiled. At least it didn't on my machine. So I did the same thing with the newest GCC again, with 8.2. That's pure compile time and test time. It took me another week to debug my script. And basically, we have relatively almost the same here. So somehow on the newest version, native optimization took a big hit on my machine. That was maybe I don't have the newest CPU, that could be it, but I that was yesterday and didn't have time to figure it out. But we can see that the link time optimization also brings the last 2% performance on top of the profile. So to sum it all up, 12% free performance, I will take that in my daily work. And I will also introduce that to our Jenkins build server next time. Okay, that was that. Thank you for listening. Ooh, think we have time for questions, or if there are any.
How did you get the profile information from the bootstrap? Because basically you have to run it twice, right? So you have to run it once.
Basically, GCC brings that with it. So the question for YouTube is, where did I got the profile information? The normal bootstrap is already for GCC is already 3 compiles after another. And if you don't make profile bootstrap, then it automatically records the profiled information on the second compile and uses it for the third one. We had a second question.
Did you also measure the impact of CC
tests? No, so the question is if I measured the impact of CC cache, so basically I put that under optimizing the I/O for that thing. So that's pure compile on RAM disk, the times itself.
And my question goes in the same direction. It's about using the PyFlag or temporary file system for the temp.
Hmm?
Is it really effect on the compile time? Because I would suspect that the operating system would do much of this optimizations to caching the disk access in RAM.
So the question is if the disk I/O is such a big problem. So basically, that was from earlier times in my career when I still had a mechanical hard disk. There it was noticeable, but now with an SSD, basically, the moment I have full core, 100% CPU all the time of the compiler, I don't care anymore about disk I/O. So yeah, this was. Only low-hanging fruits. Yeah. I think that was it. Thank you again, and we have another talk now.